Welcome back. This week we're going to be focusing on building different versions of parts that are all very, very similar in SolidWorks. And we're going to be using the configuration tool to do this. We're going to start off looking at a model train trestle. My son's gotten into model trains recently, and there are these little stanchions that hold up the track so that it can kind of go off of the ground, rise up, and go over a bridge and come back down. And so what you need is you need little stands that vary from being about 2 inches tall all the way up to maybe 6 inches and then back down to 2 inches. They all look exactly the same except for their height. And so I'm going to show you how in SolidWorks we could model these and build just one model for what that stand should look like and then make a bunch of different versions of that. I'm going to go ahead and draw it in SolidWorks, and I'll actually just record the screen and make it go kind of fast so that it doesn't take a ton of time to model it. And then I'll come back and talk about how we're going to configure that part. All right, so here's my basic train trestle. It's for a 3-inch rise. Pretty simple there. You notice that I used a mirror. So I drew half of it, then I mirrored it to get the other side to be completely symmetric. And then I used the offset entities to draw the center section and cut it out. Now I used offset entities for design intent. It's more important to me that the cross section here be a 1/4 inch than this be a particular height or width. And this is going to be important as I start to change the height of this. So if I wanted to edit how tall this was, I could actually go back into Boss Extrude here. And if I just highlight it in the feature tree, it shows me the dimensions. And then I could double click on one of the dimensions and go ahead and lower that. And if I click on rebuild, then it will shrink the part, okay? Now I could save this, and I could save it as a 2-inch trestle, and then I could change it and save it as a 3-inch trestle, and then change it and save it as a 4-inch trestle, and so on. However, I would like all of these to be tied together so that maybe if I add a particular feature or something like that, it goes on to all of the individual parts. The best way to do that in SolidWorks is to use configurations. And configurations are found in the third tab over here in the Property Manager. And you can see by default, there's one given, one configuration. And I'm going to call this my 2-inch trestle. Oops. Okay. Now, if I right-click on the part, I can go to Add Configuration. Okay, and I'll give it a configuration name. I'll call it my 3-inch trestle. And I can give it a description if I want, but for now, I'm just going to go ahead and leave it as a 3-inch trestle. And now I can change in my build materials options, I can change whether it shows the part name or the configuration. I'm going to change it to configuration. That'll just help with drawing titles and so on. And maybe I'll add one more. I'll call it my 4-inch trestle. Okay. Now, you can see if I double click on each of these, they become active, right? So only one configuration can be active at a time, okay? But if I go back, I have my 4-inch trestle highlighted here, and I go back to Boss Extrude, and I'm going to edit this sketch, okay? And now you'll notice that down here I can change my 2 inches to 4 inches, and here I can change whether that dimension applies to this configuration, all configurations, or just a specific set of configurations. And in this case, this is the dimension that I want to change with this configuration. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this configuration and hit check. Okay, and I'll rebuild the part. Okay, so now I have a 4-inch version there. If I go back and I click on my 3-inch, it's still actually 2 inches because I haven't modified it yet. So I'm going to do the same process. I'll click here, get my inch value there, and notice if I do it that way, I can only change the value here, which would make it apply to all configurations. So what you actually have to do is come in and edit the sketch, and then when you double click, you get the dialog box where you can input 3 and say it's just for this configuration. Okay, and I'll exit the sketch. And now if we go to configurations, we can see a 2-inch version, a 3-inch version, and a 4-inch version. Okay, you can make as many as you want. Very powerful tool, especially when it comes to assemblies. If you're going to have the same part in different versions in an assembly, it's easy to configure them right within building an assembly. That's all for now. See you soon.